Hello, I'm Charles Dick. You know, if I could have just one wish this holiday season, it would be for all the children of the world to join hands and sing together in the spirit of peace and harmony. If I could have just two wishes this holiday season, the first would be for all the children of the world to join hands and sing together in the spirit of peace and harmony, and the second would be for $30 million a month to be given directly to me, tax-free, in a Swiss bank account. You know, if I could have three wishes this holiday season, the first would be the crap about the kids, of course, the second would be the money in the bank account, and the third would be for nothing short of absolute divine power over every living being and the entire universe. Or, no, wait a minute, maybe the absolute power thing should be the first wish, because, I mean, the world's already a dumpster fire, the whole thing could just go boom tomorrow, and then what do you got, you know? No, the kids. Kids singing would be great, that would be really nice. Who am I kidding? They're not even going to be able to get the kids to sing together anyway. I mean, these days, the logistics of the whole thing, it's impossible. I mean, not counting the COVID regulations and the masks, they're going to have the kids standing way too far apart to be able to hold hands anyway. It's more trouble than it's really worth. So, let's reorganize. First wish, we'll go with the absolute power thing. I think that seems like the right course of action. Second wish, the money. And third and finally, the kids. Oh! I forgot about revenge against my enemies. Okay, I need revenge against all of my enemies, and I mean all of them. I would eradicate them from the face of the planet! That would be my third wish. And my fourth wish, of course, would be for all the children of the world to join hands and sing together in the spirit of peace and harmony. Thank you, everybody. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Good evening. As our final presentation tonight, the drama department wanted to bring you a reading of a well-known Christmas classic. As we were deciding what to read, we thought of Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol, Dr. Seuss's How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Eventually, we decided on John McTiernan's Die Hard. Mr. Sherry overruled this, so tonight we bring to you Clement C. Moore's A Visit from St. Nicholas, more famously known as 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. A Visit from St. Nicholas. 'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads.
And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter.
Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below.
When what to my wondering eyes did appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer?
Was a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment he must be St. Nick.
More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
As leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys, and Saint Nicholas too.
And then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney Saint Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler, just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled! His dimples, how merry! His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry! His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow.
The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself.
A wink of an eye and a twist of his head soon gave me know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work.
And filled out his stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his fingers aside of his nose, and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew, like the down of a thistle.
But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all a good night." Happy holidays, everyone. Enjoy this extra special time with your friends and family, and remember, yippee-ki-yay, my friends.